So good morning everybody. My paper today will be on the assessment of severe subnormalities in advanced glaucoma patients undergoing trabeculectomy and correlation between the two. Okay. So coming to the introduction, POAG, as we all know, is a multifactorial optic neuropathy characterized by progressive RGC death and tissue remodeling, followed by visual field defects corresponding to the NRR damage. However, all the patients with glaucomatous damage do not have elevated IOP, and the neuropathy seems to progress even with IOP in the lower teens. So these facts basically compel us to contemplate to find other associated factors causing damage and subsequent progression of the disease. Compromised ocular blood flow and deranged vascular autoregulation are emerging as the two most important factors. So in my study, a retrospective analysis of 500 patients who underwent trabeculectomy with or without cataract surgery was done. The inclusion criteria was patients with advanced glaucoma with severe subnormalities. Exclusions were was one without severe subnormalities. So every patient underwent preoperatively a complete anesthetic checkup, a cardiologist evaluation, and a physician evaluation. The severe subnormalities were classified and subgrouped and further statistically analyzed in relation with the type of glaucoma. So coming to the results, in 500 patients, we found 87 patients with concurrent severe subnormalities. They were further analyzed with respect to age, gender, type of glaucoma, and the cardiac conditions. So about 82.8% patients were above 60, 62 were male, and 37 were female. So as you see in the pie chart, about 60% of patients had POAG, followed by NTG, followed by PSCG, PXF, and ocular hypertension. This was a distribution of the type of glaucoma we found. Coming to the distribution of the cardiac conditions, as we can see, about 48.3, that's around 50% patients had sinus bradycardia, followed by hypertension, followed by IHD, and then followed by the other conditions like sinus tachy, poor RVA progression, the bundle branch blocks, valvular heart disease, and VPCs. So sinus bradycardia was found to be the most common concurrent cardiac conditions in patients with advanced glaucoma. Coming to the distribution, case-wise distribution, amongst the sinus bradycardia patients, about 60% patients had POAG, followed by NTG and PXF. However, there was no statistical correlation which we could establish between these two. Amongst the hypertensives, 73.3% had POAG. Amongst the IHD patients, again, 50% had POAG. Coming to the bundle branch blocks, amongst the RBBB patients, 33.3% patients had POAG, followed by NTG and NVG. This is the distribution based on the disease. So as you can see, most commonly occurred cardiac condition was sinus bradycardia and almost all the types of glaucomas. Coming to the discussion, as we know that the vascular mechanisms of glaucoma include PVD and compromised ocular blood flow. Autoregulation is necessary to maintain a constant ocular perfusion pressure. This autoregulation is lost in cardiac conditions as well as conditions like aging, arterial hypertension, diabetes mellitus, and all others. So this is one of the postulated non-IOP-dependent mechanisms for glaucoma. The same mechanism of PVD is also seen in concurrent cardiac conditions. So as we can see in the conclusion that these cardiac conditions do contribute to the primary vascular pathology of glaucoma and they can act as independent risk factors for diagnosis and progression of the disease. Sinus bradycardia and hypertensive in POAG NTG patients, RBBB and LBBB in NTG, NVG and POAG patients, ischemic heart disease and angle closure glaucomas are significant risk factors for the diagnosis and progression of the disease. Hence, these specific glaucoma patients with these conditions must be treated slightly more aggressively with setting of lower target IOP and should be monitored frequently to look for signs of progression. Further research is required in the individual subtypes of the cardiac conditions and whether concurrent treatment of the same can help prevent disease progression in glaucoma. Thus, this study tries to establish a scientific association between serious disorders and subtypes of glaucoma and opens up